Hey guys, welcome to Math Class with Ms. Brown. Before we get started with today's lesson, make sure you guys subscribe to this channel for more fun math videos. And make sure you guys like this video and share it with your family and friends. Now let's get started with today's lesson. In today's class, you guys are going to learn how to multiply using an array. Here is our criteria for success, and it says, create your number of rows depending on your first factor. Then put dots in each row to create your columns depending on the second factor, and then add up all of the dots to get your total. So simple, right? Well, let's jump into the first equation. So here we have 4 times 5, right? And we have our criteria for success, and it says create your number of rows depending on your first factor, and our first factor is 4, right? That's our first factor, and then our second factor here is 5. Okay, so we have to create our rows, right? How we make rows is we look at our first factor, which is 4. So the rows is going to go up and down, up and down. So just think of an arrow going up and down. That's the way your rows are going to go, right? So we have 4 as our first factor, which is our row. So I'm going to go ahead and take my dot, and I'm going to start my row. So I have 1, 2, I'm going to line that up and make sure they are lined up, okay? That's very important. 3, and then 4. So we have 4 rows going up and down, okay? That's how we create our rows. 1, 2, 3, and 4. 4 rows, okay? So then, now, we are going to put our dots in each row, right? We're going to put dots in each row. Right? And that's how we create our columns. That's how we create our columns, okay? And we look at the second factor. And our second factor is 5. So in each row, remember, in each row, we're going to have 5 dots, okay? That's our second factor, 5. So the columns are going to go from right to left, left to right. That's how our columns will go, right? So we're going to take a dot. Gonna go ahead and make a second one. So that's number 2 in the first row, right? We already had 1 dot in the first row. We added 2, 3, 4, and now 5. So now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. We have 5 dots in the first row. Now here's the second row. 2, 3, okay, 4, and 5, okay? So now we have 5 dots in the second row. 3, 4, 5. Yep. So now we're going to do the third row. All right. 3, 4, and 5. There we go. And it's very important to make sure that your dots are lined up. Okay. All right. Sometimes it's hard to get it to be lined up perfectly, but just make sure they are lined up. So here's our last row. 3, 4, and 5. Okay, we don't want our dots all over the place. Just make sure they are lined up. Try to get it lined up as best as you can. Okay, that's very important. Okay, all right, so now we have 4 rows with 5 in each, right? So 4 rows with 5 dots in each. So okay, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Okay, so we have 20 all together, okay? We have 20 dots all together. That's how I know 4 times 5 is 20. Wasn't that cool? Yes. So now we are going to do a second one, right? So we have 6 times 2. Remember, follow our criteria for success. In order to get our number of rows, we have to look at the first factor. And our first factor is 6, right? So remember, the rows go up and down, right? Up and down, up and down. So I'm going to take my dot, right? And I'm going to start with my rows. We need 6. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I have 6 rows up and down, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then, okay, so now my second factor is 2, and I'm going to place 2 dots in each row in order to create my column, okay? And I look at the second factor, which we already said was 2, right? And I'm going to put 2 dots in each row to start my columns, okay? So now let's do it. We already have 1 there, That's two, okay? That's two in that row, okay? We already have one there, okay? That's two right there, two in the second row, okay? So remember, each row already has a dot, okay? You're just adding on to get that total amount of dots in that row, depending on what your second factor is, okay? So as you can see, I have two dots in each row. All right, so now what are we going to do? What are we going to do? Yep, we are going to add up them all. All right, so that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We have 12 all together. Yes, 12, 12, 12. Super cool, right? All right, let's do another one. Okay, so now we have 3 times 5, and here's what I want you guys to do. I want you to pause this video, get your paper and pencil, and try to create your array on your paper, okay? Make sure your dots are lined up, and then after you are done, we're going to come back and do it together. Okay, you guys should be done. So, all right, so we are going to create our rows, right? By using our first factor, and our first factor is 3. So I'm going to go ahead and make sure that my rows are going up and down, okay? Because that's the direction that they go. So I'm going to start with my first dot. 1, 2, and 3. That's it. So now, remember, now I have to put dots inside of each row, right? In order to create my columns, and I look at the what? Second factor. Yes. So the second factor is 5. So each row is going to go, each row is going to have 5 dots in it. So that's 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay? So 5 dots in the first row. 2, 3. Okay, 4, all right, and 5. There we go. So now let's do the last row, which is the third row. 2, 3. I hope you guys was neat when you were doing your dots on your paper, okay? That's very important. Make sure that you are neat, organized, and make sure they are all in the same row. So I have, okay, I'm counting up. All right, I counted 15. Did you guys get 15? All right, good job, good job, good job. And if you didn't get 15, here's a tip. When you're counting off your dots, just make sure you cross off each dot as you're counting so you don't miscount, okay? All right, so remember, the more practice, the better you'll become. Okay, that's the end of today's lesson. You guys did amazing. Remember, it's going to take more practice. But before you go, make sure you subscribe to this channel, like this video, and share this video with your classmates and your family and friends if they need help in math. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram at Miss Brown_the_math_teacher and on TikTok at Miss Brown the math teacher. I'll see you guys in the next class. Bye.